Something I've mentioned before is, I mean, this matters more in ranked than in pubs. This is pub, so it doesn't really matter. But if you're in late game and there's no boxes, because the closest boxes were there in zone, that your teammate can get to when you rest, consider if you can maybe drop one of your weapons, right? Because you having, for instance, only an R99 and him having your wingman is going to be considerably more value than you having two guns and him having none. That's just something you want to think about real quick. Same for like grenades. If you can give him nades, that already gives him a way to back you up from distance, even if he doesn't have an armor. I'm going to start playing ranked more too. Never thought of it that way. Here's something that people never think about. When you get into ranked, people are anxious because losing in ranked is like a mental punch, right? That people take ranked very seriously. And because of that, they take losing ranked very seriously. And they're very, very focused on winning and playing safe. Something you have to keep in mind is that any rank you've achieved in Apex, you cannot lose. If you've hit Platinum, if you've hit Diamond, the lowest you can go is rank 4 of that rank, and you can't fall below there. So there's actually nothing to lose if you lose 200 games in a row, right? So instead of being like, oh, I'll play more ranked next season, spam the games now, get that experience now, so that when the next season starts, you have that experience, you have that extra skill boost to play ranked better next season. Like, once you realize that there's nothing for you to lose, even if you solo queue, and you just start playing ranked where people are actually tryharding, actually three stacking, and most importantly, actually punishing you for making mistakes, you'll get better so much faster. And you might notice that you don't get any wins. You might not get a lot of kills. You might do 1,000 damage every game for one kill, right? But because you are actually forced to be punished for mistakes, you're going to be get better. You're going to be getting better so much faster that if you then go back into pubs after, like, let's say 2 weeks of just spamming ranked every time you get on, you're going to be doing so much better, right? Because you're forced to actually play smart and think about what you did wrong. Okay, if this nade hits, it doesn't matter, right? Like, just logically, there's nothing you can do to follow up on this as long as they are still in zone. So wasting this nade here just doesn't make any sense. Because, like, all you've done now is make it more difficult for you to see them. So, like, what's the point? You just wasted a nade, and nades are powerful in the endgame. You only have two, so that's a bit stupid, isn't it? And, like, okay, so the nade made it more difficult for you to see them. Or did you see them drop? If you saw them drop, then what I'm saying is stupid. Let's just check. Yeah, frag would have even been better for the knockback, but I didn't see them drop, right? So, okay, off the fact that we haven't seen them drop, you throw a nade on them to make it difficult to shoot them for whatever. There's no value in it, but whatever. You can see them. And so instantly you're like, all right, they don't exist. Now I'm just going to stop LOSing them. I'm just going to stay in this area where I'm open and exposed to the person I just saw on the rock. This is like if you're playing hide and seek with a 2-year-old and he's like, if I can't see them, they can't see me. That's not how cover works, Star. Just because you threw a thermite doesn't mean you should stand out in the open exposed to this team so that you can look below where there's no threat on you. What are you doing? Bronze gameplay, bro. Right now you remember that they exist. Wouldn't it be nice if this zone, I mean, I'm pretty sure that this one doesn't push them off the rock, right? Because you pinged it and it's in zone. But it's very likely in 20 seconds that the next zone is going to push them off this rock. Wouldn't it be, like, really awesome if they had to go out in the open here or there? If you had a thermite you could throw on that open rotation? Wait, what did I miss? Why are you jumping off? Is it to make it a more fair fight for the enemy? Because that would make total sense. What? Okay. I'm not going to mention anything about the push, Star. I'm not going to mention anything about the push because I would lose brain cells. But instead, okay, let's just say it was a good idea to push up here. And not use your brain, which it's not, but let's say it is, right? Okay, you see this first guy, you laser him. So far, so good, right? You can probably finish him. Then you see another guy right behind him. All right, a little bit more risky, but you've lasered the first guy, so not too bad. You can probably still win it off of superior mechanics because it's pubbed and it's not ranked. So far, still fine. No complaint, you still have your Q off cooldown, still fine. Then you see the third guy, okay? Not so much fine. That's why you drop off, right? If you've already done this damage and bothered to fuck up your positioning to push this, and you're gonna have to back off because there's three, why wouldn't you do that with your portal, right? So that you and you can get back up here and not let them deal all this damage or heal up all this damage for free and actually get value out of your stupidity instead of just negating it by dropping off entirely. Just gonna let you think about that one for a second. Like, what's the point of this knock if you're not gonna use... Well, you don't have a zipline, right? Because Tom is dead. So, what's the value out of this? If you're not gonna have a way to get back up there? Because now they know you're here, and aside from the ultimate, if you did try to climb back up, they would laser you, right? Or he could force them out with a down frag. Possibly, yeah. But it was your ulti, fair enough. Can't see anything because of the sun, that sucks. Okay, you just pinged an enemy up there. I don't think I saw one, but let's just check if I maybe missed it, because I was kind of hoping that your nade was gonna bounce off the dome, because it would have been funny. The volume is too low to actually hear if you're hearing an enemy. I'm gonna guess you saw one. He said he downed Jibby, so I insta-ulted. Alright, yeah, that's not too bad, because just like a frag that can force them off the high ground, and then you can still get value out of that push, just like you would maybe have with this portal. So that's absolutely fine. I just couldn't see that it was yours, because the sound on this VOD, even at full volume, is really, really low. So we're not really able to hear much, except for Tom, who for some reason is the only loud person. But yeah, if you are standing here, and for some reason you're contesting out in the open instead of from behind this truck, or head glitching the rock, or anything like that, and you're contesting out in the open because that's fun, and you see that there's an enemy team right there, then you probably want to get out of here, right? Because that just means that you've got people on high ground here that you can't really contest because you don't have a portal. You've got people on high ground here that you can't really contest. And so you probably want to have them fighting each other or have one of them forced out with zone rather than ending up in between these guys. Right? So that's not something you want to deal with. Oh yeah, you wiped him with the Mastiff. Nice. Okay. Still though, in that case, it's even more so if they are dead, okay? Which means that this is no longer a threat situation. And you see people here. Why are you challenging them from here instead of where you can now play behind this truck or behind this rock? Right? Because if they are dead, then this is certainly a safe area to play with. And you have no excuse. Like, even this staircase right here would be 100 times better cover than this one pole that you are not really even using. You know what I mean? So, doesn't make any sense. Let's just take damage out in the open for no reason. Poor cover usage, you mean no cover usage. Like, if you get pressured in a situation where it's not expected, or if there's too much going on and you're just quickly responding to things, you're trying to pressure people out of peeking you, in all of those situations, I don't usually mention if you're not using cover well, because that's natural, right? It's a reaction to put pressure back, to make sure that you can't be pushed for free, and that is fine. But that's not the case here. You're just not using it for no reason. My ulti again to push them off of ship. Yeah, you're playing decent, yeah. Isn't the area I'm in now at the platform, final circle? Yeah. But the circle isn't moving yet, so he doesn't need to stand on the open platform. Like, here's the thing. What does it matter that... hold on. Back here. Okay. What does it matter that this is final zone when the zone isn't moving yet? If he's going to contest these people, he could do that from cover, and then when the zone moves, because he's closer to this and they have to traverse the open area to push him, that's when he can move up where he has less cover. You know, he's only contesting for the sake of shooting. Exactly, he's only standing in the open here because he wants to shoot. And not because he's thinking about the final zone, because there's no value. Like, if you are standing here, you're not only still in final zone, but even if you're standing behind that rock, if you're out of the final zone, you can still stand there for 30 seconds. They have to traverse the way all the way in the open here, and all you have to do is take this step forward to the truck, or here to the staircase, and you're already holding the final zone. Like, the only way that they can, like, there's two enemy teams left, right? So one is here, the other one we don't know yet. The only way that an enemy team can contest this zone from you is if you're fighting this team and over-focusing like you're doing now, and they unexpectedly come from below. Right? Or from behind on... Can they be on the ramp? They would have to go through zone a little bit, but they could still potentially kind of come from behind there. Mainly the zipline, right? This is where awareness matters. You know that there's one team you haven't scouted yet, and so you want to make sure that they're not able to sandwich you here or contest the final zone by keeping an eye behind you on the zipline, on the redeploy, on stuff like that. Instead of over-focusing on this team, which, if you don't take too much damage, is going to have to traverse pretty much out in the open when you have a, you know, a dominant position already. Right? So over-focusing on this team doesn't make any sense, especially out in the open. But you knew that already. Gibby is the ultimate aggro legend. Eh, I mean, in pubs maybe. But yeah, the Wraith should generally be more aggro. I mean, here's the thing. Gibby is the most aggro legend in 1v1s, just because if he has decent armor, he can always win any damage exchange if he forces you out of cover. If you're like in a room, and the Gibby can just walk in the room with you and just put his gun shield in your face, and you both have equal armor, or he has better armor than you, then there's no way that he loses that damage exchange. You know what I mean? If he has decent aim, obviously. If he's not a potato. So in that sense, in 1v1s, yes, Gibby is actually a very aggressive legend. It's just that it's usually not a 1v1, and if he has to fight multiple people, his hitbox is huge, so he's gonna get lasered. But that's where he's not aggressive. I was supporting Star, actually. I went for kills because they were focused on him. Yeah, so Star went up, Niu dropped his ultimate and pushed up to help, and Star, I guess, didn't call that he was disengaging, which is why Niu is still focused on that fight. Niu is playing Gibby, which means he doesn't have a disengage, which means you need to call early that you're going to disengage there, otherwise he's going to end up stuck on that enemy team, and he's going to have to outplay them to win the fight. Now Niu, luckily, is a way better player than that team, so he mastered them to shit, and Star did do a lot of opening damage. As much as we're making fun of him, he did do good damage at the start of that fight. So it ended up working out, but that could very well, if either Niu was a lesser skilled player, or if they hadn't taken a lot of damage yet, or if they weren't absolute potatoes, that could have ended up very, very poorly for him if you don't call out early that you're gonna dip. As a Wraith, you can always just queue out and you'll probably be fine. Gibby, not so much. Hey, what's the game plan here? You're focusing on this one team, you don't know where the other team is yet. At least as far as I've seen, unless I've missed it somewhere on the pausing. But right here, right? Boom. Okay. You guys are holding zone. You know that they either have to drop down here and then push you out in the open, which is fine as long as you are holding cover, because then you can punish them for being out in the open. Or what they end up doing is they go all the way below there, and then the only risk to you is that they either use a Pathfinder zipline, or they use the zipline behind you there that we were talking about earlier. So if you see them drop all the way down, then obviously, you know, keep an eye on that zipline, and you can laser them for free if they get up. Same for if they use a Pathfinder zipline. All you have to do is hold this high ground. But the one thing you need to be conscious of is, where is this third team, right? There's one team you're missing and you don't want them to sandwich you. So all you have to do is not put yourself in a Papega position. And what do you end up doing? You end up pushing out in the open, and instead of using the rocks you have in front of you or something like that, you just go stand here. Like, look at this rock you have here. Look at this somewhat decent head glitch you have here. Like, look at all the opportunities you have. Why are you gonna go stand up here? Doesn't make any sense. Real quick, Dan, remind me of the relationship between game sense and awareness, since it was mentioned above. I mean, they are very much overlapping, and it kind of depends on who you ask. But awareness is more so just trying to keep track of everything around you, and game sense is more so your ability to predict what's going to happen, right? So game sense is kind of knowing all the facts about the game that you have to use to make decisions, like what are the damage of certain weapons, what are hitbox animations, how do abilities work, how long does a bubble stay up if a Gibby drops it. Those are all kind of game sense. Those are pieces of information, you know, that are static, that don't change, that you can then use to predict what's going to happen or how you should play. Awareness are all kind of the variables in a game, knowing where enemies are, knowing where enemies are going or moving, or like who they're focusing, and then using that information to make decisions as well, right? So they're both pieces of information you use for your decision making, but game sense is more like the static information that doesn't change, knowing the map, knowing the legends, knowing the weapons, etc., etc. And then awareness is more so all the variables. Where are the enemies? What are they doing? How many of them are there? How many teams are left? Those are all awareness. Right, so you're not using the high ground that well, but at least you're still in a somewhat decent position here. Jibby bomb. Wait, are you going to drop down? What? And so you still only know where one team is, right? Or was this more than three people? Let's check quickly. One below. I've passed so much, I don't even know. One below, one on the ship. Two on the ship, I think. Three total, right? Yeah, I thought so, but I paused so much I didn't want to say something wrong again, because that happens sometimes when you pause this much. So one team that you've seen here, you still don't know where that last team is. Now, you haven't seen them in this long in such a small circle. This is probably a rat. But again, this is the kind of position where you don't want to get pushed from your back without expecting it. So the fact that you're just completely tunnel visioning this team is just kind of risky. I think it was three, yeah, but I'm not entirely sure. Either way, it's not two teams. So I'm guessing you were dropping on them. Oh, you found the rat. He was there. Now you're out in the open again. Oh, there's the Jibby bomb. Nice. Right, they end up taking a position out in the open where as soon as the bubble ends, you're pretty much in a straight aim duel, which you're gonna win because it's you and you in pumps, right? But again, no valuable positioning whatsoever. Gave up the high ground for no reason when you could still be spamming up there. Never really checked like where that rat was in time. There was a lot of opportunities for you to get sandwiched that you like never really even responded to. Mainly just completely avoiding cover whatsoever.